this is the main equipment trolley, and here we have almost all the equipment that we use for laparoscopic surgery. The upper platform has the monitor, and usually this is at the eye level, and we have a fairly large monitor here, which is a flat panel, which gives us a good resolution. The second platform has a camera. This is a three-chip camera, a digital one. Then we have the recording units. So we have two types of recordings. One is using the computer, where we have a digitizer. This is the hardware which is used for digitizing the camera input, and then we take it into the computer, which can be used for editing also. Then we have another DVD recorder, which is a simple recorder with a hard disk in it, so we can store a number of videos into this hard disk and edit it here and burn out a DVD every day. This is an ordinary halogen light source, which has a double source. In case one gets burnt out, the other can be used. And we have a xenon light source, which is more expensive but gives us very good resolution. This is a gas insufflator, which is an automatic high flow gas insufflator. The trolley is on casters, and this can be moved very easily all around the operation theater. And we have all the plug points, all the electrical points coming to one place, and from here we have the safety unit, the fuses and everything. And this would go with a long wire cable, and this will be fitted onto the wall. This cabin, this trolley also comes with one large cylinder fixed on a base that is attached to the back of the trolley over here. We have all the wires wounded and tied and kept together, so that they don't keep hanging around, and only what is required is taken to the plug points. There are multiple points here. First, this is the camera unit, and this camera unit can have a lot of outputs. And these depend on what type of monitors that we use and what type of recordings that we use. We decide which output to take from the camera. Now, this is the best output, which is called the digital output. This camera has two digital outputs, and these are called DVI outputs. Now, we have taken one cable out of this. We can also take one more cable from the other output, either for recording or to another monitor. There are two inputs for remote control to be used, and we have fiber cables that can be connected to the camera. This will come in R, G, B and C, that is red, green, blue and composite outputs from the camera. Then we have a little less resolution outputs. There are two SVHS or S video outputs and one video output, also called a composite signal. This is a Sydney, and these two are advanced outputs which can be used to have a digital circuitry which will connect throughout the operation theater, and we can connect all the systems in the operation theater into one single computer and manage the whole equipment from there.
So these type of outputs can be used for such advanced features. This is the power cord going out of the camera. The monitor can take different types of inputs. One is the power cord here, and we have the SVHS cable connected here. We have the DVI cable connected here, and we have a composite signal here, and we also have a computer monitor input here. So there are several inputs here which can be connected. The digital input here, and then the video, composite video, the SVHS, and an ordinary RS232 input. This is a hardware used to convert the signals from the camera into a digital signal that can go into a computer. So we take the in from the out of the camera into this hardware, and then from there we take the signal directly to the USB on the computer. There is a extra card that is inserted into this computer which takes all these signals and then converts and records into the hard disks. This is a capture card, which is a hardware which is used to take the signals coming out from the camera and then convert them to a proper signal that can go into a computer here. So we have the S-video signal coming from the camera into this capture card, and from here we take the USB signal which is going to the computer here. 9 kilo cylinder, and there is a high pressure of the gas inside this, and this high pressure can affect the gas in circulator. So we have a reducer, a pressure reducer attached to the cylinder, and from this pressure reducer we take the cable which is connected to the gas in circulator here.